Hello students,
in this video we are going to learn one of the long answer questions from Denoyer's theorem chapter. Okay, let us see question. M n belongs to Z, m n are any integers. X is given as cos alpha plus iota sin alpha, y given as cos beta plus iota sin beta. Then show that, okay, we have to prove these two results. Let us write the given complex numbers first. Given data, given that x equals to cos alpha plus iota sin alpha, y equals to cos beta plus iota sin beta. If you observe these two proofs, we are able to see x power m term, y power n term. In both the proofs, we have x power m term, y power n term. So before we go to the simplification of these results, let us find what is x power m and what is y power m. Okay, let us find first x power m. If x is given, I can find x power m. X power m become cos alpha plus iota sin alpha whole power m. Time to use Denoyer's theorem. If you remind Denoyer's theorem, cos theta plus iota sin theta whole power n formula, cos n theta plus iota into sin n theta. So just power n multiplied to angle part. That's why n theta, n into theta, n theta, n theta. So if you apply the same logic here, this become cos m alpha plus iota into sin m alpha. So this is x power m. Similarly, we'll find y power n. What is y? Cos beta plus iota sin beta whole power n. So according to Denoyer's theorem, power multiplied to angle, n into beta, n beta. So cos n beta plus iota into sin n beta. Okay. After getting x power m, y power n individually, now I can find x power m into y power n. X power m into y power n. So here we have to multiply these two complex numbers. So as you know already, sis theta 1 into sis theta 2. Let us remind formula. Sis theta 1 into sis theta 2 formula. Sis of theta 1 plus theta 2. So whenever you have product of two complex numbers, better to write its simple form. Instead of cos theta plus iota sin theta, write sis theta, sis. X power m can be written as sis. What is theta here? M alpha. So sis m alpha into y power n, y power n, short form sis n beta. Then it look like sis theta 1 into sis theta 2. Sis of theta 1 plus theta 2. Sis of theta 1 plus theta 2. M alpha plus n beta. So this is x power m into y power n. So in next step, okay, to get the two proofs, we have, if you see first proof, we have plus between the terms. So if you have plus or minus between the terms, original form we require to write. Okay, short form is not preferable. Okay, original form. What is its original form? Original form cos. Cos of sis theta. Sis theta original form cos theta plus iota sin theta. Cos theta. Theta is m alpha plus n beta. Plus iota into sin of m alpha plus n beta. Now let's go to first proof. In first proof, we will take x power m into y power n plus 1 by x power m into y power n. Let's go for substitution. X power m into y power n. Cos of m alpha plus n beta plus iota into sin of m alpha plus n beta. This is x power m into y power n plus 1 by x power m into y power n, reciprocal. So what is the reciprocal of cos theta plus iota sin theta? You know, reciprocal of cos theta plus iota sin theta is cos theta minus iota sin theta. This is the basic thing. So reciprocal of this one become just sign change. Okay, now plus become minus. So plus we have to replace with minus. These two terms we have to write same. Cos of m alpha plus n beta minus iota into sin of m alpha plus n beta. Now on simplification, this one gets cancelled. Both are having opposite signs. So the next step is nothing but you are required to fighting two times same terms, 2 cos of m alpha plus n beta, 2 cos of m alpha plus n beta. Now we will see second proof. What is second proof? Just minus 1 by x power m into y power n. So similar simplification, just we have to replace plus with minus. Okay, that is right, same iota sin of m alpha plus n beta. Due to minus, sign changes takes place among. Due to this minus, the terms sign changes takes place. So we are plus, in place of plus we will get minus, in place of minus we will get plus. Cos of m alpha plus n beta plus iota into sin of m alpha plus n beta. So this time minus cos of m alpha plus n beta plus cos of m alpha plus n beta gets cancelled. Now we left with two same terms. So 2 iota, 2 times 2 iota into sin of m alpha plus n beta. 2 iota sin of m alpha plus n beta. Okay? So these are the two proofs.